Another fellow, it's one of our, a couple of our young adults, in other words. And she actually, I believe, just got her MPH.
Oh, she did?
Yeah, here locally. Uh-huh. In any case, I might be wrong about that. Maybe it was a master's. But in any case, so they're going to come back and...
That'd be super.
Yeah. You know, what we did here is we had an ER doctor here last weekend. And it just, you know, you had the family thing going or something to where you couldn't come when we originally scheduled you. And it just worked out to where the two dates came together. And I thought, well, this is going to be Health Emphasis Month. And it really has been quite good to have both perspectives. And anyway, I know that folks have gotten a lot of help. And I want to thank you very much for coming. And we would like you to come back.
I would like to.
Okay.
Yeah, it probably would have to be next year since it's only 2
Yeah,
years.
No, yeah. Okay.
We'll talk on the phone.
All right. All right. Okay, well, doctor, please come to the mic and share what's on your heart and what the people need.
Thank you, everyone. And what I want to do is go through real quickly what we saw in the blood, because we didn't have time to really explain it like you probably would like to me to have explained it. That's good English. I don't know whether it is or not. By this juncture of the day, the mind gets tired. But anyway, let's go through the easy ones first. We saw in some of you, probably in a lot of you, iron deficiency. And now, iron deficiency, I told some of you what to do, but I want to clarify it, because what I told you, that if you would take blackstrap molasses, it would give you the iron than which your body needs, which is true. However, if you have blood sugar problems, I wouldn't do it. If you do the green drinks, which we have talked about, you know, last time I was here, and I would like to just go over that real quickly, and if I can, Pastor, I'm going to send you a copy of the green recipes, which I thought I had, but I didn't even have one with me. And I'll bring that with me. But the greens is an antioxidant. There's a lot of value to it. It also will help you to alkalize the body. In other words, you need to bring your pH levels up above a 7. And if you do this on a daily basis, it'll do that. And it's full of iron, minerals, calcium, magnesium, potassium, and trace minerals, in a very natural way in which the body can absorb it. Now, I've had people ask me, why don't you juice? If you have terminal illness, I would juice it. But if you don't, you need the whole plant. You need the fiber and everything that goes with it. And by having the whole plant, you're going to get in the whole plant, you're going to get chlorophyll, enzymes, live enzymes. And the enzymes, it makes your body run. I couldn't raise my hand like this without enzymes. Enzymes are critical in the body. And when we eat mostly cooked food, we end up at some point becoming ill because of the lack of enzymes in the system. It has calcium, as I mentioned, and other minerals. It has vitamins. It has water. It has just a variety of nutrients that your body needs. So you want to take the greens. And the way we do it is several ways. I'll only tell you one way today because I'll send the recipes for the interest of time. But we use basic...
The green drink?
Yes, ma'am. Uh-huh. And so what we use is parsley. And I usually use Italian parsley if you can find it. But you can use the other parsley too if you can. I use also kale and spinach. Now, spinach raw is very nutritious. Spinach cooked converts to oxalic acid and it blocks calcium absorption. So you don't want to eat spinach cooked. Now, if you do, I love spinach pasta. I have to admit, I like it. My wife makes it, I like it. And once in a great while, it's only going to block that one meal. It's not like it's going to block it continuously. But you don't want to eat it on a regular basis. Now, Popeye was partially right, except his was all cooked. So he probably had osteoporosis, if you really think about it. So anyway, you want to do that. Now, what we would do is wash it thoroughly, put it into a blender, and you need a liquid. At home, we use water. But you could use one of three juices. You could use pineapple juice, apple juice, or vegetable juice. Mix it. If you're using the juice, mix it half water. You don't need all that sugar. You're just doing it for flavor, to make it taste better. Now, we don't do that. We peel a small lemon, leaving the white underneath. The bioflavonoids is what's in the white of the meat. And then I cut it up in three or four pieces. I put it in the blender along with the greens and the water. I put a little bit of good quality Himalayan or sea salt in with it. I blend it to a liquid, and we drink it. Now, the way I do it definitely tastes green. But if you want to cover the green taste up, use one of the juices that I mentioned.
Pineapple, apple, what was the
vegetable juice. Uh-huh. And so, anyway, now you do not want to use V8. V8 has monosodium glutamate in it, MSG. So you want to get your vegetable juice from the health food store, the Knutson or Knutson, however you want to pronounce it, brand. You can buy organic, would have none of those types of things in it. Okay. The next thing we saw was B vitamin deficiency. And B vitamin is very prevalent in vegetarians or people that eat very little meat. And one way to get it naturally, and this is how I get it, I use nutritional yeast. And I take one tablespoon a day when I'm at home. And the way I do it, I love bread. I'm a bread eater. And I was up in Seattle here about a month ago, and they told me about a brand of bread called Dave's Bread. And it's just now being carried in Vons. It comes from Portland, Oregon. It's got all whole grains, nuts, seeds. It's really a good bread. It costs you a dollar or so more a loaf, but it's worth it. So I toast the Dave's bread, and I put flaxseed oil on it, and I sprinkle my nutritional yeast on top of it. That's how I eat it. It tastes delicious. If you do that, you'll never go back to butter. Well, I won't say you'll never, but I hope you don't ever go back. I'm sorry again? I still didn't understand. Oh, the pills? You could take the pills. Sure. Oh, sure. Yeah. Yeah. Yes. I toast it. I put flaxseed oil, not the meal, flaxseed oil. I pour it on, and then I take my nutritional yeast. I usually have two pieces of toast, and between the two of them, I use a tablespoon and put on it. And it tastes great. I'm sorry, ma'am? That's all I put on it. Exactly. All right. So that's one way to get your B vitamins. Or you can supplement with a B complex if you want to. But make sure it's plant-based. Always check to make sure that you're getting plant-based vitamins and minerals. Because if you don't, I'll give you a quick example. I don't want to spend a lot of time tonight on this, but maybe next time I come. Is that in back of my place, we're on the side of a hill, partially. And in the back, there's rocks. And if those rocks were calcium, there's no law that says I can't grind those rocks up, put them in capsules and sell them to you. But they will not absorb very well. So you don't know what you're getting oftentimes, unless it's a company that you have faith in. And there's so many of them out there, you don't know. So you definitely want to make sure it's plant-based. If it's plant-based, it's going to absorb. You'll get probably the majority of the nutrient that you're paying for. Yes, ma'am?
Do you have G-A-L-A?
I'm sorry, again? I'm not familiar with it.
Yes, kind of
a
new line, and it's all plant-based.
Okay, no, I'm not familiar with them, but it sounds like it might be all right. Let me take one more question, and then I want you to hold your questions. Otherwise, we're going to be here for an hour, and I want to get going in about 25 minutes. If you're really low on B vitamins, go ahead and do that. And let me just tell you this. The big thing that I saw today is two things. One is digestion. You may be taking all the B in the world, but it's not assimilating in many cases that we saw today. And we need to get the digestion working. When we hit about age 45, and I'd say the majority of people sitting in here right now are there. I'm trying to be kind. And anyway, as a result, our hydrochloric acid in our stomach, it starts to diminish. And then we start getting acid reflux. Or we might be getting bloating. We may be constipated. We may have diarrhea. We may have a whole variety of different things and symptoms that come up. And the problem is that not that we have too much acid, and antacid companies like Tums and Rolaids and whatever else is out there would like you to believe that you have too much acid and you take this and it neutralizes. What does it do when it neutralizes? Your food is not digested. It will not digest because you've neutralized it. The problem is you have too little acid, and the body has to work overtime, and it churns and churns, and sometimes the acid is pushed up. It burns right here, or sometimes comes all the way up. We are miserable because it burns so bad. It's very painful. Well, the best thing to do is to stimulate the body to make the right amount of hydrochloric acid to break your foods down, and you won't get the burn, you won't get that problem. So what I've recommended to you guys is two different ways. And one would be you can use lemon juice before a meal. At least a tablespoon of lemon juice will stimulate your body to make more. But the easy way, and some people that are Adventists have problem with this because Ellen White said we should not use vinegar, and I totally agree with that. But apple cider vinegar is a different formula altogether. I'm going to leave this to your choice. I'm not trying to change anybody's thinking. But it shouldn't even be called a vinegar because it's actually an acid called malic acid. And malic acid is from apples. That's why they call it apple cider vinegar. And if you take a tablespoon of that in water, I want to stress it has to be in water, 6 to 8 ounces, because it can burn you if you don't. It will stimulate your body to make more hydrochloric acid. And you do this maybe up to a half an hour before you eat. And if you forget, you can do it closer to eating time, or if you have to, you can do it with eating. I know we don't like to do liquids, but at the same time, this is stimulating the digestive juices rather than depleting them. So you need it for digestion. And I have to do it myself. I don't do it every day now, but I do it enough times to keep my hydrochloric acid production up. But at first, you need to do it with every meal as best you can. Now, when you're traveling or away, going to church, going to a store, whatever it may be, you don't want to carry a bottle with you. But when you're home, I would take it. And you can get, at the health food stores, apple cider vinegar pills. They don't work as well, but they're good for travel. Okay, that's very critical. Okay. Well, the alkaline water, I think, has its place. But you have to be careful with it because it'll neutralize your digestive juices too. So you don't want to drink alkaline water at least 30 minutes before a meal or an hour and a half after a meal. But then you could drink it after that. And so you shouldn't drink water anyway during that period of time of any kind. But anyway, the alkaline water. There's a lot of alkaline waters. The Kangen water, there's several different varieties out there today. It does a lot of good. I've seen it work well with people with cancer and other diseases if they use it the right way. If we deplete our nutrition and our digestive tract even more with the water, it's not really helping. So we need to be on purpose and know that we need to wait after we eat at least an hour and a half so that our digestive juices will break what's down in the stomach. And we shouldn't do regular water, 7.0 water, that way either. Okay, the next thing that I saw is on the list was parasites. And now a lot of people want to know how to get rid of them. Well, you can. There's products that'll help, and then there's natural ways. I'll tell you both. The natural ways, first of all. What I recommend to most people, if they can do it through their work and they're not going to offend people by their breath, is to take garlic. And you want to take garlic for a minimum of 2 weeks. And you want to take enough of it, but you need to take the raw garlic. So you're going to smell, you're going to reek of it. You can take the parsley and chew on that afterwards, which will help, but it won't 100% take it away. You need to take about 4 cloves if you're 150 pounds or less. If you're more than 150 pounds, you need to take more than 4. I would take it once a day. And the best way, which I've talked to some of you about, is to put it between a piece of bread or put it on bread, because the bread will keep it from burning. And I know it's not the most pleasant thing to eat.
Can you put it on the salad?
Put it on what?
Salad.
I don't see why not. Sure.
Just
one time a day. So that will kill parasites. It'll take care of your intestinal parasites, which we can't see in the microscope, unless there was a stool sample. But with the blood, it'll show the systemic parasites, which are very tiny little protozoa, is the name of the type of bug that we see in the blood itself. So this helps. A product. There's a number of products you can buy. There's herbs you can use. It takes a little while with the herbs, but you can use black walnut, wormwood, and black walnut, wormwood, and clove. And you mix them in equal proportions, and you want to take maybe 6, make a capsule out of it. Buy a capsulator at the health food store for $10, and use veggie caps. Double-aught is what we use. That's how they measure the capsules, by aught, double-aught, triple-aught. Aught is zero, two zeros. And then take 6 of those before bedtime all at the same time for about 2 weeks.
Uh-huh. I'm sorry, black walnut and herb?
Black walnut, wormwood, and clove. Uh-huh. Okay, that you can do that. Okay, another way to get rid of parasites. Yes, sir.
Just wondering, how much does that equal in terms of table food? Let's say you don't want to use the capsules.
You take it one time, you'll want the capsules. They taste so bitter. Okay. I would say that equal maybe 1 tablespoon.
But you just kind of blend it all together.
Right, exactly. If you want to mix it and take it that way, you can do a tablespoon in water, mix it in water, and drink it down. It is quite bitter. Okay, but it works. That's the whole thing. It works. Another thing, there's a product that you can get. It's a liquid. It's called Natural Cellular Defense. It's a special liquid thing. It kills candida and also kills the regular parasites. Natural Cellular Defense. And Natural Cellular Defense, unfortunately, is a network marketing. And the name of the company is Waiora, Waiora. And you can find them online. It's called mywaiora.com. Mywaiora.com, Waiora. Waiora, Waiora.
And they sell the natural cellular defense.
I'm sorry, ma'am?
They sell the natural cellular defense.
Right, natural cellular defense.
Is it grilled or
It's liquid. You take drops. And if you're interested in it, call me. I'm not trying to, I didn't come here to sell products, but I do deal with that. So if you want help on that, just call me on that. Like I said, I didn't come here to sell it. So you can buy it directly to them, or you can buy it from through me, which is the same cost.
Will that take care of Candida if you're not dialed?
Yes, it will. Yes, it will. And Candida albicans is a fungal infection that usually comes from antibiotic use. What happens is the antibiotics kill off the good bacteria, as you know, and over a period of time, the cells in the colon become larger. And what happens is that foreign matter can get into the bloodstream, including fungal infections. And actually, food allergies come about as a result of that as well. But anyway, if you need help, call me. I'll help you on the phone. I don't charge for telephone consultations. Did you get one of my cards?
I did.
You get one? Okay, my number is 760. And please don't all call tomorrow because I won't be able to handle it. 364-3462. Yeah, and they'll probably get a voicemail and tell me when to call you, what time of day. And I'll try if I possibly can. Okay. Anyway, let's talk about Candida for a minute, because I did see it in some of your blood, not everybody's. But what I would do to get rid of it, well, you can do the garlic with that. That'll also help. You can do the natural cellular defense, or what we call NCD. But one thing is very important, that you've got to take a probiotic with it. You get a probiotic. You can go to the health food store. Yes, ma'am?
It's the liquid probiotic, and it's like really strong. The coconut water. Are you familiar with that one?
I've heard about it. You know, I have an opinion on liquid ones. Liquid ones, are killed off in the digestive tract easier than the capsules. It's not? Okay. We'll take your word for it. All right.
Is the Gero probiotic a good one?
I never heard of it. I'm sorry, I don't know. Well, there's a lot of good ones. Just go to your health food store and talk to somebody. But what you want is multiple strain. You don't want it to be just one. And if you have a lactose intolerance, make sure it doesn't have lactobacillus in it, because it comes from milk. So you want, if you're not allergic to the milk at all, then maybe you might want to take lactobacillus. But you want to get where they have strains. The one, I've seen them as many as 18 or 20 strains in one capsule. And that can be up to 18 billion count of bacteria on manufacturing of those heavy strain ones. And they work the best. And the best thing for that is that you want to alternate probiotics. Use one bottle up, buy a different brand, because you get different bacteria that way. So it's a good idea to do it that way. And how long should you keep going on it? If you've had a lot of antibiotics, I'd do it for at least a year. It's a good idea to keep it up. And even after that, maybe once in a while, take one. Keep.
And if you haven't had an antibiotic,
it's okay just to. It might be. If you had Candida or something like that, yeah, you probably should take it.
But otherwise, you really don't know when you need it.
No. No, not always. I mean, not normally. But let me just tell you something. I could probably ask in this room how many have never had an antibiotic, and maybe not one hand would go up. Almost everybody's had antibiotics. And even if you had one when you were a child, it's done its damage. And so, anyway, I used to ask how many people's had an antibiotic. Well, every hand just about go up, so I'd go the other way now. Okay, I'm going to need to move faster because I do want to try to get going here by about 6 o'clock. Well, I'm close to Palm Springs, but I'm further. I'm about a half hour further. Yeah, but it's a long drive. and particularly if there's traffic on the five and also the 15, which there was on Friday when I came. Yeah. But anyway, yes, sir. Would somebody try?
Can sugar be adjusted in the blood by garlic, with garlic?
Oh, no. It'll kill the parasites. It would be really a good idea to take the garlic. I'm sorry. My hearing isn't that great, so.
We're confused on the probiotics, but why are we taking that?
For the re-establish the colon, the friendly bacteria. And it will help to get rid of candida in a mild way. If you have severe candida, it's not going to help much. But if you have a small amount of it, it will. So, but we still need to keep it from coming back, so we got to reestablish that. Okay, real quickly, I saw dehydration. Well, you know the answer to that, drink water. That's an easy one. And how much water? We talked about yesterday, 1 ounce of water for every 2 pounds of body weight. Well, no, because if you're taking vitamin B supplement or multivitamin, it's going to turn yellow. Yeah, so you can't tell by that. If you're not taking vitamins, then maybe you can tell by that. Yes, sir. I'm sorry, I'm not hearing. Oh, what they look like, they're flat. Like real flat. And then a hydrated person looks real puffy. They look like those cells need to go on a diet. So anyway, that's what they look like. All right. Yes, ma'am.
1 ounce of water for one
hand. You take your body weight, cut it in half, and that's how many ounces you need. Yeah. Free radicals? Okay, I'll just get to that one next. Almost everyone has some free radicals. Some of you, in fact, at least half of you, had very severe what's called oxidative stress. Now, what's oxidative stress and free radicals is the fact that we talked about a little bit yesterday, but we didn't get into any detail, but it's an atom. Because everything's made out of atoms, it's lost one or more of electrons that float around it. They're very small. They will take one out of the cell to make themselves whole. The cell will die. And that's when you see what you hear about oxidative stress and the damage it does to the body's killing cells. Not only blood cells, but other cells. It could be brain cells all the way down to your feet and everything in between. So we need to do something as an antioxidant. And now you can buy vitamin E, vitamin C, selenium, a variety of things that work. However, I think the best, I always try to go to diet. And the best thing is to add berries to your diet. Blueberries is the highest that grows in our country. The higher than that would be pomegranate juice. If you want to get something really strong, you can get goji berries. They're so expensive. I would say just go with the blueberries, strawberries, raspberries, blackberries, or pomegranate juice. As I mentioned yesterday, the strongest is dark chocolate. But you don't want all the junk in it. You got to get healthy dark chocolate. And there are companies that make it that's healthy. And you can, it's still sweet. They use natural sweeteners rather than granulated sugar or corn syrup. And so... go to your health food store and ask for it.
Chia seeds were very high. Chia,
I'm sorry?
Chia seeds.
Chia seeds are very high. Very high. Yeah. But then again, that's imported. I was trying to find things that are grown mostly in America. But, of course, chocolate isn't. It comes from Africa and other places. Okay. What's next on somebody's list? Digestion. Okay, digestion. We already kind of talked about it with the apple cider vinegar. And so that pretty well takes care of it. What's that?
Lemon juice would do
Lemon juice will do the same. Yeah. All right, let's hold your questions because we only got about 10 more minutes. I've got to go. What's that? So, okay. Circulation would be because of digestion most of the time, because it clumps together. That's one part of it. The other part of it is the fact that our red blood cells have lost the negative charge. When they're born, as I mentioned yesterday, I say that so you don't think I'm senile, that they repel. And so it loses this negative charge. How does it lose it? It can be from too high fat diet, for one thing. A person has too high fat diet, it'll cause this clumping together, hurting the circulation. Well, you can also have areas of the body where you've injured and it causes the circulation to be hindered. So, but the main thing, how do we get circulation going? Eat a proper diet. Get your digestion working and then exercise, breathe deeply, drink water, get rest, the 8 laws of health. That's how you do it. Sister White said in Ministry of Healing that perfect health depends upon perfect circulation. And I believe that. I believe we have to have perfect circulation in order to have good health. Yes, ma'am? I'm sorry?
Yeast.
I still don't.
Yeast.
Oh, yeast. Okay. Well, the yeast we talked about, that was the candida. That's candida. Okay, let's talk about toxins. Please hold your questions because I do want to get going here pretty quick. And the yeast are the toxins. Okay, that's very important. We need to cover that and how to do a detoxification. Okay, one thing is that most everyone in the world today, not just America, has toxins in their body. I think I mentioned this, but about 3 years ago, they did a study on umbilical cords on newborns. They found that the average baby coming to this world had 278 or 279 toxins. And that's a lot of toxicity. Now, how many more toxins do you have and I have because we've been around a lot longer? And keep in mind that some of these chemicals inside the body can create what's called a supertoxin and can make us sick. So we need to get rid of the toxins. The easy way to do it is to take something, and that natural cellular defense product I told you about will remove heavy metals, chemical toxins, and toxins out of the body. It takes about 90 days to get most all of them out. But if you want to do it a little different way, what you could do is eat clay, believe it or not. Eat a small amount of clay. We use bentonite clay, which is a white clay, but you can use also European clay, which is green or blue. And you eat... Where do you get it? You can get it from health food stores usually. Yeah, they'll have it. And I would suggest you take a teaspoon in water every day. Now, if your bowels start to get bound up, stop long enough to clean your bowels. You don't want to get constipated. Now, you can also take charcoal every day. Charcoal will do it, but it's a slow process. But it was a slow process for you for these toxins coming into your body. So it might take months, and it probably would. But that's one way you can do it.
So you can take about 2 cans of chocolate together?
Yes, you can. Yeah, you can take it together.
About 2 cans a day, and you take it in the capsules?
Charcoal? Yeah, I would take it a couple times a day.
About how many?
Well, you don't want to overdo it. If you're going to take it continuously for a while, maybe 2 capsules twice a day. Two twice a day. And like I said, don't let charcoal and don't let the clay bind you up. And if you have a tendency towards constipation, you have to really pay attention to that. Another thing you need to do is drink lots of water. Drink the water. It'll flush out toxins. Very, very important. And I'm glad to see you reach for your water when I said that. So anyway, you want to definitely drink water during this time. It's your detoxing.
They said that when you're diabetic, you should not take, you should not drink a lot of water after in the evening. But what I do, each time I eat, I replenish with water. Is that
good? I think it's okay. That's my opinion, but. You know, you got to listen to your doctor too. We don't want to go against the doctors, what the doctors say. But at the same time, I think we need water to be able to flush our system and clean it out. Because if we don't, the toxins will accumulate. Now, I'm going to have you hold your questions because we're not going to ever get through it if you guys keep asking me questions, if you would please. So anyway, you need to clean the bowels once in a while. And you should make an internal poultice. Now, I gave a couple of you a formula how to make an internal poultice. One is use charcoal, clay, and psyllium husk. You want the husk rather than the seed. And this is the proportion. It would be one part charcoal, one part clay, and three parts psyllium. Mix them together. And then take a tablespoon. Actually, it's better to take a teaspoon three times a day. And that's going to help to pull out toxins that are buried in your colon and your digestive tract. Again, be careful. Keep your bowels moving. Remember, the bowels, you can take before bedtime a little bit of overdose of magnesium. That'll definitely move your bowels. Or you can take the herb Cascara Sagrada. Or you can take Senna Pod. Senna is another one. I don't like it, but anyway, the reason is harsher. Or you can take Turkey Rhubarb. Those are herbs that you can use for cleaning the bowels. Okay? Maybe one more, and then we've got to quit. One more thing. Crystals. Okay, crystals, basically, if you want to get rid of them, you drink distilled water for a little while. That's about all you can do. And watch the cholesterol levels that you have in your body.
I'm very concerned because I lived in Banning, and I've driven back and forth, and I know it takes about 2 hours and 15 minutes or so just to get that. Yeah, it's a three-hour drive. So if he leaves right now, he'll get home a little after 9 o'clock tonight. We don't want him to do that, right? All right. So Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I appreciate it. So get out of here.
Okay, I'm out of here.
No more questions.
Let's have prayer.